Okay, I just picked up this cassette recorder at the thrift store for $3.99. It's a Panasonic Slimline. And they also had the GE there, but it's pretty similar to the one I have. And I know GE loves to be DC biased, so I passed on that one. So this is the Panasonic. I also got this Radio Shack microphone. Let me see. 33-2001A. Dynamic 500 ohms has a remote switch on it, although this does not have a remote jack. And also I got this pause control for a remote jack, and this cable must be like 20 feet long, but it's just a switch. It's not a microphone, so it's kind of unusual. Made in Japan, but there's no brand name on it. So, kind of interesting. 99 cents, so I couldn't pass it up. So, I did a little test recording on this Panasonic, so we'll see how it sounds here.
Okay, I'm testing the Panasonic Slimline cassette recorder, model RQ2103. I'm using the built-in microphone right now, and I'll switch over to an external Radio Shack microphone. Okay, now using the Radio Shack external microphone. This is a rather basic model cassette recorder. It does have a pause button and cue and review, but no remote jack, no tape counter, no AC input, and no record level indicator. It just runs on 4C batteries or a DC 6 volt input. And it only has a mic input, no aux input line level, and there's a monitor jack for speaker or earphone. So we'll see how this turns out, and I don't know if it's going to be DC bias or AC bias, so we'll find that out also.
So it's kind of distorted, but the sibilance, the S sound, is pretty clear, so it could be either very good DC bias or AC bias that needs some adjusting of the bias to get it to sound better. But the belts are good. It rewinds and fast forwards really fast. There's cue and review. That's not music I recorded on. This is music some other tape recorder I made, but so it's kind of tinny sounding, not a very full-bodied sound, although it would be better with an external speaker, obviously. There's also no tone control on this, so that's the Panasonic Slimline cassette recorder, RQ2103, made in Singapore. Probably early 80s, although that's just a guess. In case you're wondering how the Radio Shack microphone sounds with a direct hookup, normally if you just plug it in, you only hear it out of the left side because it's only a mono microphone. So I made this little adapter cable here, and we'll just plug it into the adapter, which takes the mono output and converts it to both channels. Now you hear the Radio Shack microphone coming out of both channels, thanks to the little adapter cable I made. This is a 500 ohm impedance dynamic microphone by Radio Shack.